Hello friends, once again welcome to your favorite pharma channel Ram Pharma Academy. Myself Mr. Ram Rao Fad, assistant professor at Maharashtra College of Pharmacy Nelanga. As you know, most of the students don't find interest in learning, so to increase their interest in learning, teacher has to do something different. So I thought I must create crossword puzzles on the pharmacy education. So this is going to be the first crossword puzzle in the history of YouTube. So if you like the video, please like and share the video with all your friends so that they also find the interest in pharmacy education. So what we have to do, if you have sufficient time, take pen and paper, and on the paper you have to draw this crossword puzzle, then try to solve it. I think all of you know how to solve the crossword puzzles. After this timer, we'll try to solve it. Friends, it takes lot of time to create this type of crossword puzzles. So please like and share the video with all your friends and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. On this video, to learn various pharmacy topics, puzzles and tricks, please subscribe to Ram Pharma Academy. The next pharmacy crossword puzzle is also coming soon. So let's get started with the first crossword puzzle on the pharmacy education. What look at in the across. The first is a protein molecule that receives chemical signals from outside a cell. What is that protein which receives the chemical signals? Chemical signals means the drugs which binds with this protein molecule and conveys the message. What is that protein? That protein is known as receptor. I think most of you have got this. Then look into the down section. First is hormone released by juxtaglomerular apparatus is. You know the juxtaglomerulus apparatus. It is on the nephron. So hormone released by this juxtaglomerular apparatus is. It starts with the R. And the name of that enzyme is the hormone known as renin. Renin is the enzyme which involved in the conversion of angiotensinogen into angiotensin 1. You must have learned about this in the renin angiotensin system, RAS, during the hypertension topic. So the answer is renin. Then second point in the down, a small container with medicine inside that you swallow whole. What is the name of that container in which you have to put the medicine and then you are going to swallow it whole? It starts with the C. So what is that container? It's a capsule. I think most of you have got this one also. Then in the across, the third point is functional unit of kidney is. I think most of you know what is the functional unit of kidney. What is the answer? I think you got it. It's nephron. So the answer is nephron. Then next is the fourth in the across. Fahrenheit is denoted by letter. Fahrenheit is the unit of temperature in which you have to use the F letter for the Fahrenheit. Then next, fifth in the across, unit of turbidity from nephelometer. You must have learned the nephelometry and turbidimetry. So the unit of turbidity from the nephelometer is the, you know what is it? It's NTU, nephelometric turbidity units. So this is the unit of turbidity which is given by the nephelometer, apparatus used in the analytical chemistry. Then next point is the seventh point in the across. A common infectious illness that causes fever and headache. What is that common infectious illness that causes fever and headache? It's a three-letter word. So what is it? It's flu. In the flu is the infection, easily get viral infection in which you get the fever and headache. So this is the common infectious illness. Then next is the sixth in the down section. A clear liquid secreted by the lacrimal glands found in the eyes. What is that liquid which is secreted by the lacrimal glands present in the eyes? It starts with the T and it's a four-letter word. What is it? It's tear. So this is this clear liquid or secretion produced by the lacrimal glands from the eyes. Then next is the seventh in the down section. A hormone associated with reproduction and development of ovarian follicles in women. So in seventh position we have already the F letter. So what is the hormone which involved in the reproduction and development of ovarian follicles? It starts with the F letter. I think most of you got it, FSH. So FSH and LH are the important hormones which are involved in the reproductive system and development of ovarian follicles. Then next is the in the across section, the 8th number, an immunological assay commonly used to measure antibodies, antigens, proteins and glycoproteins in biological samples. It is one of the important technique used in the diagnosis of different types of infectious diseases like tuberculosis, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, HIV. So the answer is, you can see at the 8th position we have already E, then L, and it also has S in the name. So what is that test which involve in the, which is the immunological assay commonly used to measure antibodies, antigens, proteins and glycoproteins in the biological samples? It's ELISA. Okay friends, so this is one of the important tests used in the diagnostics. Then next is the 9th in the down section. Vitamins A, D, E and K are diet soluble. You know, vitamins are classified on the basis of solubility into two types, water soluble vitamins and fat soluble vitamins. Water soluble vitamins are B and C vitamins, while the vitamins A, D, E and K are the fat soluble vitamins. So here our answer is fat. So this is the answer of the 9th, which is vitamins A, D, E, K are fat soluble. Then next is the 10th in the down section. A covalent bond which is formed by the side to side overlap of two atomic orbitals. This is the definition of which bond. A covalent bond which is formed by the side to side overlap. If it is end to end overlap or head to head overlap, it is known as sigma bond, and the bond is formed by the side to side overlap is known as the pi bond. You must have learned about this. So the answer for the 10th is the 10th down is the pi. And then the next 10th point is in the across section is the prostatic artery embolization is abbreviated as. It's very easy how to abbreviate prostatic artery embolization. It's PAE. So what is the importance of this prostatic artery embolization, or do you know what is prostatic artery embolization? It is the minimally invasive technique or the treatment involved in the improvement of lower urinary tract symptoms which are arised due to the benign prostatic hyperplasia. What is benign prostatic hyperplasia? It is the enlargement of the prostate gland. Do you know what is difference between benign tumor and the malign tumor? So this is the benign prostatic enlargement or the benign prostatic hyperplasia. It is different from the prostate cancer. So whenever there is increase in the size of prostate gland due to the benign tumor, it causes the, or it creates difficulty in the urinary system, which can be improved with the help of this prostatic artery embolization, which is abbreviated as PAE. So this is the answer of 10th across. Then 11th across is the radiation used in vibrational spectroscopy. Answer is already with you. 11th number is IR. So what is IR? IR is the infrared spectroscopy. So vibrational spectroscopy is also known as IR spectroscopy. So the radiations used in vibrational spectroscopy are the IR radiations. Then 12th number is the, in the across section, is one letter code for arginine is. You must have learned about the amino acid. Arginine is one of the example of alpha amino acids, and alpha amino acids have one letter codes, three letter codes. For the arginine, the one letter code used is, what is it? It's R. Okay friends. Then last point is 13 across. Digestive tract is known as gastrointestinal tract. So here our answer for the 13 across is GIT. So students, I think you must have created interest during this solving the crossword puzzle. We are going to make crossword puzzles again in this series. So if you really like the video, please like and share the video with all your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. It takes time to create this type of videos. So please like and share the video with all your friends and stay connected with the channel. Thanks for watching. Goodbye. Take care.